Friends to do it for you.
Not enemies.
Enemies be even more better.
Why?
प्रशांत भी ह्यूमन है
एलियन से ह्यूमन में आ रहा है
डोंट नो या सो दिस इज हाउ यू नीड टू ओपन अप फ्रॉम हियर
फ्रॉम बिलो अप फ्रॉम
या फ्रॉम अप फ्रॉम बिलो ऑल द वे फ्रॉम हियर फ्रॉम द डोंट रोल इन द जॉइंट नॉट हियर ओके सो दिस इज वेयर द थाई स्टार्ट ऑलराइट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हियर फुल पुट फुल प्रेशर इट्स ओके ऑन द साइड एंड स्टार्ट रोलिंग वेरी स्लो
कभी कभार थोड़ा दर्द भी रहता
है मर्द को दर्द
मंजू सर नहीं आया सर मंजू सर वैसा तो एल्बो डाल को
मंजू सर को बेलन मिलाने नहीं है
टर्न टर्न पिसाई
टर्न टर्न टर्न
आगे विकास भैया
So side way, side side. No, no. Put one leg on the Put together, together.
Double chapati.
So if you have IT band pain here, you can start from here.
We can put oil also.
Namuro. Namuro absent.
Namuro absent.
IT band.
Yeah, from here start rolling.
Who will do, sir?
चपाती मॉर्निंग चपाती पूरी
सर आपको
मैं बेचारा 58 के लिए सर रिजर्व भी नहीं पूरी
मतलब चपाती
चपाती ये प्रेशर मैं क्या बोल रहा
हूं भोजन
मेरा वाला बेस साइड चेक था इसलिए मैं प्रेशर वाला लेके बैठा है एक भी प्रेशर वाला
पुट यू कैन पुट हाउ मच ऑफ प्रेशर यू वांट
ये रिवेंज
है
बिकॉज़ रिवेंज है
बट बी केयरफुल डोंट रोल इन द जॉइंट ओके नेवर टच द बोन ओके
Ramanjan.
Yes, you can do some stretches, partner to partner stretches, very important. At times, you do not stretch on your own because some are inflexible and some are overly flexible, right? So, ideal stretching is important. So, one of the best things you can do is finish your run, do this roll every day, alright? On the quads, on the side, on the hamstring, on the calf, but not on the joints. Okay. So, you, and then your foot. Okay. No, no, no. Give me the ball. Why you hit the ball? How many people get foot pain? Foot pain. Lot of people. Foot pain.
Barefoot.
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 Barefoot. Barefoot.
Barefoot. This is where you need to stand. Stand. Okay. Again, stand on this. Stand. Just stand for 1 minute.
Window pakad ke.
Hello, if you take the foot off, hold. Up. That is when you stand. You can try doing this. Try. 1 minute you have to hold. You feel the way it relaxes.
So he's already relaxed.
No, Prashant is not.
To keep the
Prashant is not.
We have 8 kilometers now.
सिर्फ
Other leg also should go. You should have two balls.
Sir, let him do it simultaneously.
Both sides. Both sides. Both sides. Both sides.
Both sides. Both sides. Post run, yeah. Just watch.
Bend it on there. Now, match the ball.
Hands, hands up.
So, all you're doing is post run.
All right.
Okay, again. So you just hold like this and try to help your partner. That's
no,
the
pressure.
Okay, hold for 15 seconds. 15 to 20 seconds. So when you hold, slowly try moving this.
Okay.
So it opens the spine beautifully here, the mid spine.
Smile for Prashant, you are on the camera.
Prashant, beautiful.
Hey, smile for the camera, no?
Okay.
There will be so many girls who watching that video.
So don't push anyone too much hard, okay? Just see how much they can go. All right, so this is his range, natural range. All right, so that is why if you see Prashant's strike also come up so well. Because it's already the hamstring length.
But somebody is touches the nose, then I don't know what they'll do.
Okay.
This location.
So first like fight.
Yes, sir. Nose touch karate from.
Tumara yoga mein
hai.
Okay. So and then even here, what you do is slowly push forward. 1, 2.
Yoga mein karate na.
4. Open up. 5. 6. Rather than just holding it here. Okay. Slowly palpitate. Okay. About 15-20 counts. You don't have to do too much. And then slightly open up again. Again. 15-20 counts. Okay. And again slowly.
This is about 50% bhi nahi aayega.
Again 15-20 counts.
Ravi Shankar sir, tomorrow
so
when camera nahi dikh raha
hai. Your hands are here, so that this does not come off. Mm. All right, your hands are here, or it placed down firmly. Okay, relax. Okay, so you've got a hamstring stretch. Okay, another one more thing to lengthen the hamstring. Down. Okay, push up, down, push up, down, push up, down. Okay. So another one, again for your glute. So fully all the way to his chest. Okay? This gets stretched. So the glute. This for the glute.
Personal physio rakhna sir.
And the IT band again from here. Alright. Stretch. Just see how much he can do, that's all. Not more than that. If you try doing more than that, you'll snap his back. Alright? Again here.
Prashant, kuch bol, bas bol.
Smile.
Kuch to bol.
Baksh do.
Saans le raha hai, wohi chal raha hai.
Okay. Just touching the IT band. Lay down on the stomach. So we stretch the hamstring, we stretch the IT band, we stretch the glute. Okay. And we also stretch the groin. Lay down on the back. So now what we have to stretch.
Prashant.
Hip. Just stretch the hip. Hands forward. Lift this up. Okay. Okay. It's a very nice stretch for the hip. Stretch forward. Fully. Yeah. Okay, again, hold for 15 counts.
So now rather than the two.
This is.
Prashant, kala pani.
Do it on humans like.
No, we need someone who could. Yeah, definitely. That's what he's telling. You need a partner.
You need a partner, yeah.
No, no. Someone should know the techniques of doing
it. That's what I'm saying. Don't overdo it. Very smoothly. So you ask your partner, how are you feeling? You talk to him. See, now I know. All right. See, with the range, I know. That there's only so much you can do for him. Mm. Alright, you try overdoing, you'll tear something. Mm. Right. So for example, if you try overdoing here, you know there is all the abdomen muscles here. Mm. Right.
So you have to do it on
humans. Or tear the pants.
So not on aliens.
No, lay down on the stomach again.
You have done all things on only one side.
Okay.
No, I mean relaxed on one and
relaxed on another.
We feel everything but everybody will be like this.
Okay. So this
for some other one.
Six pack abs. So it's okay, relax.
That's painful.
So these things and all, here. So there's something. Here the TFL, okay.
This is all censored.
But it has been done with the camera on.
With the camera, yeah.
Censored with the camera on.
So here, there is this.
Nowadays, everything is locked away.
See this joint here, right?
Yeah.
Just above
yeah.
the joint.
Yeah.
Okay. Just above the hip joint, that's it. You just release here because a lot of tightness here again because of sitting. Here, just above the hip joint, we'll find this.
Ingo inner
okay,
ligament.
Here.
In there?
Ligament, ingo inner ligament.
Mm-hmm.
No, sir, it's ligament. So now, massage the ligament.
So now, drag your foot. This foot. slowly, drag. And release. Drag and release. Drag and release.
You have to see pressure on his face.
It's pretty flexible.
अंदर ही अंदर गाली दे रहा है वो
कमल
की बात
मन की बात
release so again release the hip flexors okay so these are the basic things that you can do on your own without you know much effort it'll not take you more than 5 minutes after they run you'll just do these exercises you'll feel much much better foam rolling, I don't know if everybody has foam roll, we can do a foam rolling session after they run. How to use foam roll properly. But if you do not have, then chapati stick is the best thing.
Mm-hmm.
Like how I showed a chapati stick. Okay?
Okay.
So first, finish your foam rolling and then start stretching.
Mm-hmm.
Alright? So these stretches should be mandatory every day. And one more thing is like, if you have any back pain, I don't know, some exercises. This is another awesome exercise, okay? If you have a lot of stress in your back or something after a run, already comes an Achu. Okay. So you basically sit back like this, okay, fully back like this, you stretch forward. Okay. And then forward, your hand should be here, okay, not here, okay, here. Open up the back. Okay, from here. So what we do is we do it from here, right, the yoga thing, okay. But you do it from here. You'll see a difference, massive difference in your back. Your glutes also get fired. Again, go back, post run. Fully go back as much as possible. And again, come forward, hands a little forward, near your head, and up. Okay? So, we'll go for a run?
Yes.
Yes.
burst.
Good. Come on. Come on, take a jump. Take a jump. Up. Feel high.
Stay there. Spend some time there. The point. Whatever point
is
being.
Ball is not grips and all. Ball is slipping.
And do this up and down. Leg up and down. One, two. If you're finding it difficult, keep your other leg down. If you're finding it difficult, if not, it's okay.
Okay.
Okay. Find a point.
Lift the pelvis, sir.
Yeah. Lift the pelvis. Lift the pelvis up. Okay.
Lift the pelvis.
You can use a foam roller also.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just go over and lean up.
Okay. Yeah, find.
Mara, ek aur paon upar
rakho. Find the points. Find the point. So keep rolling the ball. Keep rolling the ball.
Karo sir.
Find a point. Keep rolling.
Yeah.
Okay, keep rolling. At least spend 1 minute rolling. Up and down. Scan. Keep scanning. See where all pain is there. All the way up down. Cough. Yeah. Keep going. Keep finding. Since people don't have foam roller, that's why I'm using it. Finally, you go like this, you find the point, and you do up and down. Find the trigger point where what is hurting. If you have foam roller. Okay, full scan it, this way, that way.
With foam roller also you can do now.
Yeah, foam roller is better.
Better now.
Because you can get a lot more variety. Leg.
Will this return result there?
Will be return, right?
At least 1 minute.
Matt, that's a sir, after the touch.
Yeah.
Tell me to.
After when?
Yeah, sir.
15 days, this is
the
All this is the foam rolling city is all boring.
Yes.
I'll just skip this. That's fine.
But then you have to do boring things too.
Humidity,
So when you do up and down, where the tightness is. The moment you find the tightness, that is where you keep the foam roller and spend more time.
Uh-huh. Okay.
That is where you need to release.
Right.
Oh, here, hamstring. Okay, same. Again, put here, roll forward back. Okay.
Sir, not under knee, no, sir?
No, it should not go under the knee. Please don't take it under the knee. Only hamstring. We put one leg on the other leg. So spend some time. You feel a point? Spend. Roll forward back. See where. Even a ball is I can do. At least 1 minute.
Sir,
yes, sir.
Vitamin D, sir?
Above
40. Sir, vitamin D, yeah?
Vitamin D.
Vitamin D.
Vitamin D.
Okay. 60 minutes into that, you will get all benefits.
3 hours and spending, sir, in the morning.
Sir, quality transfer karna, sir.
Ah, quality in 3 hours. In 3 hours.
Okay,
put it below your bum. Okay, find the point.
Ultimate feeling, bolle na ba? Capture karna.
Sir, can capture the feeling.
Okay, slowly. Okay, here, here. Try to drink leg here. Okay, here. If you have foam roller, you can sit on foam roller also. Okay, find the point.
Ball is better.
Ball is better. But then many people can't sit on the. Here. But find glutes.
Can make a loop, isn't it?
Yeah, can make a loop. Very good. Come on. Leave the full weight on that and roll. And find a point and sit.
So what you do is, you go forward, back. My pain point is here. So what I do is, up.
Sir, up with pain, bole to kaisa do?
Pain is.
Baat mat karo.
Pain bhi. Again, go back. See, it's hurting so much. Full weight, I left all my weight here. You have to scream. If you're not doing, find the point. Drop.
Hold it. Hold it. Hold it.
हर जगह फीलिंग नहीं आता
नहीं
आता
बेंड करना पृथ्वी
ಇನ್ನೂ
Breathe, let go of the pain, breathe from the mind. Breathe, relax, 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 relax. Take the pain, relax, breathe, breathe. Don't resist, breathe, breathe. Breathe, yeah, breathe. Don't resist. You need to gain more strength.
Sir, man, ಎಷ್ಟು slow ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಸರ್? ಸರ್
and you won't get the pressure if you're doing yourself. You need to get it done for
something.
Okay.
Sir, what the?
Sir, TFL work in this.
Both of them have very opposite. You know, Rudra Dinakar says, eat your grandmother's food, eat your rice in the night, eat your But look, put in a case, completely avoid carbohydrates, go on fasting and all that. So they're completely different. The top few nutrition in the country have completely different opinions.
Okay.
Keep quiet.
Okay.
So now, to understand nutrition, I mean, doctors will say, I mean, you can correct me wrong, doctors will say, you have to eat egg in the morning, eat one glass, drink one glass, standard thing. You know, get your calcium, get your, you know, source of protein from meat. 99.99% doctors will recommend some meat, yes or no? Including my aunt, okay, when my grandmother got dengue, she said, give her Gomita. Because Gomita has got sugars, recovery and all that, right? As even for kids also, we recommend Horlicks, Cerelac and all that. Yes or no, sir?
I don't recommend Cerelac.
Okay. Horlicks, generally, usually. Okay. And we think, even the general public thing, that's a great thing. Okay. But to understand eating food, some people say, this is my religion, this says, my caste says this, that caste says that. Alright, so again we bring it down, food to caste, sub-caste, religion, and you know, geography and all that. So, but there are two principles for food, basically. If you look at evolution, 12,000 years of evolution, the first thing is eat local. Alright, second thing is, eat on need basis, not on greed basis. Alright, so what is local? So for example, let's say, who's a Rajasthani? You're a Rajasthani, right? Rajasthani. But you're a Rajasthani.
Alright.
You're a Rajasthani. But you are settled, where are you settled? You are settled in Deccan Plateau down here. Alright, for you eating Bajra does not make sense. Or eating wheat is not a local crop, until unless you bring it down from there and do it. But what is locally grown is the first principle to eat food. So the Muslims, alright, what they eat? They want to eat camel. Alright, they want to eat camel. During Ramzan, I don't know, if it's at least Shivaji Nagar, they eat camel, they eat a lot of meat. Alright, but that is a very desert culture. Just that the fact that they're following something, you know, what you say that happens there, they're doing it here also. Now let's say if you go to Sikkim, they drink yak's milk because yak, you know, can survive there, alright. So the first thing is, you have to find out what is locally available and what is easily growable, alright. That should be a first thing, you know, there's no point in bringing oats and eating here. How is oats relevant to you? It is not at all relevant to you because it is not conducive to this atmosphere, right?
Yeah, many times this quinoa, etc.
Quinoa not needed, alright. So first thing, whatever you ask yourself, is this grown in Karnataka, is this grown locally, is it grown naturally, alright. So second thing is, you have to cut down your dependency on animal based food, alright, be it milk, curd. You will ask me where will you get protein and all that, so I will tell you about evolution again. So we started as hunter gatherers, right? We only ate animals when we started 12,000 years back, we were chasing animals. We killed them and then we started eating animals. And then what happened over a period of time? We started getting into agriculture. Alright, then agriculture happened. And then cattle became a part of us. So instead of killing cattle, we started using cattle to grow, what do you say, our produce and all that, right?
Yield,
yeah. And then what happened? You were only using cattle food or something, milk or what do you say, curd or whatever, only when there was a shortage in your produce. Alright, but over a period of time that became a part of our culture. Now look at nature's example. Now you say milk is very important, correct? Everybody says milk is important. When I was telling yesterday, they were shocked. You should avoid drinking milk, avoid eating curd or avoid eating ghee. But look at nature's design. For how long does a mother produce milk? As a mother, how much do you produce milk? Just for 1.5 years. 1.5 years. Maximum 2 years, sir?
Two years.
2 years you produce milk. After that, why do you stop producing milk?
Because child is grown.
You don't need, nature design is you don't need. But what do you do, but you think milk is healthy, then you put your children on cow's milk. Now look at cow, after when cow or calf, alright, what does a calf do? Do you think cow drinks cow's milk all its life? No, it does not.
1 year.
1 year, that's all. Even naturally, even cows also stop producing. Then you're using artificial ways to produce milk and, you know, make them breed and whatnot, you know, pump in more injections and all that, right? So when cow itself, you should ask yourself, when cow itself does not drink cow's milk, what is your role in drinking milk? Ask yourself, when cow itself doesn't, does pig drink pig milk? No, does dog drink dog milk? Humans are meant to drink human milk. When there is a shortage, because we are intelligent, we depend on them. Let's say a mother cannot produce milk. Alright, when a baby cannot eat solid food, that is when you depend on some other animal, which is
true.
You know, because cow is domesticated, you go on that, right? If you go up north, they give yak's milk, like I said. Some people, they also give goat milk, whatever is easily available. So first thing is, animal-based products is a big no now. Alright, until unless, because there is so many other better options. You ask, where is calcium? Go ask yourself, when did you eat horse grams last? When did you eat sprouted seeds last? When did you eat, you know, greens last? All this has to be a part of every day, not you eat one day this, one day that. Alright. Second thing is meat. Alright, meat, again, it takes about, again, why do you eat meat? Ask yourself, why do you eat meat? What is the role of meat for your body?
What is the role?
Proteins.
Proteins, okay.
Proteins.
So, what meat do you eat? chicken,
all right.
Mutton, pork, fish, beef, five, okay. Now, what is chicken? Chicken is again, what does chicken eat for its protein, for its muscles? What does it eat? Grains,
seeds,
whatever you put. Does it eat meat for
insects,
protein?
Insects,
okay. Second thing is your goat. Goat is a pure vegetarian animal. Your cow is a pure vegetarian animal. Your pig is a pure vegetarian animal. Your fish is again a vegetarian animal, mostly. It is all the algae and all, most of the time, all right? Now, these animals are eating plants for their protein. Now, how do you think, why do you think you need to eat plant-based animals for you to get protein? It's a big thing. Why can't your source of protein can be plants? Why can't your source? You eat meat, okay, many people feel constipated the next day. All right. I don't know if you know that. If you're a meat eater, at least when I was eating meat, I still feel constipated the next day. My bowels were not clearing properly. So that is why when you eat meat, you eat a lot of salads. And abroad, they eat a lot of salads because you need fiber for it to break down. Because meat itself does not have fiber. Without fiber, you can't break it down. Until unless if you think, it's a personal choice. All right. It is all a purely personal choice. But if you're looking at health and if you're looking at feeling good in your body, you have to drop meat and dairy. Two things. And also, before that, what is the number one cause of global warming?
Sure.
Eating meat.
Animal farming.
Animal farming. Today, there are 1 billion cows ready to be slaughtered in the world, across the world. 1 billion cows are ready to be slaughtered. There are about some 10 billion chicken ready to be slaughtered. All right. And also, all these are farm fed, which means injections going in and all that. Now, let's say a cow needs about 30 to 40 kg of grass a day. It needs about 200, 300 liters of water a day. So now, one of the reasons for deforestation across the world is chopping of forests to raise these animals. Because you have to, if you look at UK and all, they've all been cleanly shaved off. Because they have to grow these animals. So if you really worried about the environment, the number one reason for CO2 is not in industries or anything, it is animal farming.
All right.
What is good for the environment will never be good for you. And if you're really concerned, today global warming is a big thing. All right, you already can feel it. So if you really care about our children and all that, you have to protect the environment. So what is good for you is never, what is good for the environment is good for you. What is not good for the environment is not good for you. Because what happens outside will happen to you also. All right. So third thing is you have to eliminate sugar, especially white sugar. All right, big time. You don't need it. All right. Ask yourself, what is the role of sugar? It is dopamine. For me, a sugar addict and a smoker is no different. It's the same. So there are many people, I don't know today, you're hearing non-smoking and non-drinking cases of deaths more than smoking and drinking cases of death. So many women, breast cancer, ovarian cancer, very clean life, even men also, right? I'm really saying, because they think, I don't smoke, I don't drink, doesn't mean you're living a healthy life. If you're eating so much, if you 1 teaspoon of sugar into one chai, and 3 chais a day is 3 teaspoons of sugar. Now, calculate out a period of 30 years. You'll be like, your body will process this much amount of sugar. And now what is happening? You're not even doing so much of activities these days. Yes, sugar should go away completely. So people say jaggery is a better replacement. I don't believe it. If you can have one small bite. Jaggery, all right. You can eliminate jaggery, all right. Because your fruits have sugars, your vegetables have sugars, your grains have all forms of natural sugars, all right. So sugar is just an addiction, all right. Third thing is processed food, all right. What is processed food? Your maida. Maida, bread, biscuits. Once in a week you have a cup of coffee, nothing is happening. Or once in a week you eat a cake, or it's not going to happen. But you should not make it a part of everyday life. Like your sandwich should not be your breakfast. Once in a week you go to Domino's Pizza, have a slice of pizza, or you go outside, it's not going to kill you. All right. But things like sandwiches, things like your cakes, rusk, biscuit, which is becoming a very part of life, it should eliminate from your life. You should not bring biscuits to your house. If you're going to somebody's house, please take some fruits and go. All right. Okay. If you go to some patient, don't take bread, rusk and go. Okay, take some fruits and go. All right. You know what I mean? Right? Yeah. So these basic things. I'm not saying eliminate. All right. So it should be a convenient thing. When you go for a long trip or something where you do not have access, you take these foods. Once in a week, you have it. But do not make it a part of everyday life. Like having that chai biscuit every day. How many people have chai biscuit every day?
Compulsory.
Chai
and biscuit.
Eliminate milk. Have black coffee. Black coffee. See, if you look at, if you go to the US and all, I don't know if US or other countries, pure coffee lovers love black coffee. Tea lovers love black tea. That is the taste. In India, we are more milk and sugar addicted. That is the coffee taste and a bit of caffeine that comes and works on the mind. All right. If you like coffee, it's fine. But have black coffee and black tea. Even like 2-3 cups of black coffee a day is pretty okay. Even 2-3 cups of, black tea is okay. Right. But without sugar. All right. So maida gone, sugar gone. And then rice.
How about honey? It's honey more of a fructose.
honey
so,
fructose.
So the point is, today's honey, I don't know how authentic it is. Alright, so I went to this.
Maybe it's naturally.
So my friend buys this in a store. I used to buy organic honey, okay, and I used to pay 200 rupees. Then I used to make friends. The guy told sir nothing. He, this fellow buys it from Dabur or whatever, from Big Bazaar. Big, they put his honey, they pack it, FSSI certification. Anybody can get. You paid 3,000, 5,000, you'll get a certification.
Yeah.
You'll put FSSI certified and send it. So honey is more like, you know, liquid jaggery mix and all that, all right. So somebody was saying honey with, you know, water
lemon.
In the morning. Drop honey, just have water in the morning. Just have water and lemon in the morning, if you have that taste. Okay, so sugar gone, meat gone, dairy gone, and maida gone. Maida.
What to eat?
No, that's what we're going to come. Exactly. So I also thought, same thing. What to eat? Now, what is there to eat? Now, today, now ask yourself. There are at least there are 10 kinds of grains, millets. There are this foxtail, there is proso. Every day, eat a different kind of a millet. Life is so beautiful. Why are you making it boring? You have your, maida also. Sunday, you have your maida. Monday, you have your foxtail. Tuesday, you have your proso. Wednesday you have your brown rice, Thursday you have your wheat, Friday you have your bajra. Why you're missing out on all these things is what I'm saying. And all that, and especially Ballari, you know, is known for all these dry crops.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Sir, you're talking about rice.
Rice, Johar, yeah.
rice,
okay.
Wheat is good, sir, wheat.
So again, see,
it's okay.
Like, eat variety, that's all I'm saying. So for example, if a South Indian, so I don't eat wheat. I mean, like last night we were having dinner, somebody gave, so you don't deny it. But as a practice at home, we don't eat wheat.
Chapati.
Right.
We eat lot of
wheat.
Bajra. We eat wheat ragi. Because we come from,
millets.
Wonderful, yeah. So, for us, traditionally, if you look at, when we were farmers, Samlu, Sajlu, we say in Telugu.
Yes.
Same, Sajje, Ragi. So, that is what we eat. Even now, yeah. So, we make Misibedabad, Pongal,
Navane,
of all that. Same, Sajje, Ragi.
Navane.
So, because of water, so again, rice. He wants a roll of rice, okay?
Yes.
Rice should always be eaten unpolished rice. Today we have a thing for white. Anything we think white is big. Okay, so
you tell him.
Oh, that's what.
Yeah.
Start selling unpolished rice.
Unpolished
one
rice.
More thing, as I've seen from many people, they ask for brown rice, but they are saying they do have digestion issues because
nothing.
Their stomachs are.
No, sir, that's the
quantity.
That's
the best thing.
That's the best thing. I know. The quantity is the capacity to digest it.
Unpolished
rice is very tasty.
It is not fiber, exactly. I don't believe that. Basically, you know what? No.
Very tasty.
If you do, they're eating very less. If you make food, they want to eat quite as much.
See, fiber is very effective. That's what
everything
don't stay. They take any quantity of the fiber, they feel satiety. That's the reason why the brown rice contains a lot of fiber. Bran, once it is polished, the brown is taken out. That's why you have that no effect of that satiety when you eat the polished rice. That's the reason people feel filling effect when they eat brown rice.
We'll
see
you
there tomorrow.
Okay, so
without rice, we cannot leave.
Sorry, who knows the to stop for eat rice? Eat unpolished rice. Or even
brown rice.
Brown rice, yeah. So even if you eat rice,
will be served for more than
sir,
polished
rice.
So, see, rice is not bad, okay? Do not polish. See, I'll tell you how it happens. Now, let's say for diabetes, okay, people who have diabetes, why do you have diabetes? There's a surge of glucose into the blood, all right? Why does surge happen? Because there is no breakdown of, there's a lot of load on the pancreas to produce insulin, all right? Because there's a surge of glucose, all right? So now, you take white rice and you take a brown rice. Alright, you see the difference in how the glucose rises. Brown rice will reduce the load.
Yeah.
It's as simple as that. Alright. So brown rice is better. Alright. Again, I'm saying you go out, it's okay to have white rice. It is fine. Alright. At least try to avoid carbohydrates in the night. What does carbohydrates mean? Not white rice, including chapati. So people say I'm replacing wheat with even chapati is carbohydrate. Even ragi is carbohydrate. It's just a complex carbohydrate, one is a simple carbohydrate, that's all. Alright. So avoid white rice. Eat brown rice. So eat variety. That's what I'm saying.
Prashant, procure it.
Okay.
Next Saturday.
Group meal. Allah Allah. Ballari
Rana. Apply for Ballari Rana.
Next Saturday.
What we do is Saturday.
Jowar
Ballari rice.
Jowar tastes fine.
Jowar ragi.
And also now coming back to this. Now you need to know when to eat what. All right. Carbohydrates is important. Okay. Protein is important. Fat is important. Everything is important. All right. But the point is the timing. Okay, and also the based on their activity. Now let's say farmers, all right, they can eat even white rice, all right, because they're moving all day. They're moving all day, they're burning it out. So farmers, you can't. So people like us, all right, farmers unfortunately eat brown rice, all right, you know that unpolished rice, all right. So every day we eat too much of carbohydrates. Your morning breakfast, like today morning breakfast will be idli, poha and other carbohydrates. Afternoon what will be? Ragi ball or rice. Again night what will be? Either bajar roti. Everything is still carbohydrates. Where is your protein? Where is your other stuff coming? Alright. Your diet should have substantial amount of everything. But in our diet, what's about 70% of carbohydrates?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So that is why look at your stomach, all stomach, everything, all carbohydrates sitting there. They will say night I eat only one chapati. Even one chapati is carbohydrate. Okay. Even chapati is carbohydrate, even johar is carbohydrate, even ragi is carbohydrate. Some people say listen, instead of rice can eat ragi in the night, even it is carbohydrate. Alright, so night what are you doing? You're doing nothing. Your body is just recovering. Alright. So basically, one of the best things, I tell you. So what you need to do is, in the morning you need protein. So ideally, the best way to have a breakfast is, have a lot of fruits. Instead of eating 4 idlis, eat 2 idlis and have equal quantity of fruits. Alright. So lunch can be...
See, fruits doesn't contain protein.
What's that?
Fruits doesn't contain protein.
Fruits are no protein. They've got new.
Oats also is carbohydrates.
If you're really worried so much about protein, so protein you usually need in the night. Because night your body is resting to repair all the damaged cells, you need in the night. Alright. So what I will tell you what I follow.
It is more tough to digest proteins in the night.
It's because basically you screwed up your entire digestive system. Listen. You are blaming the food. Food is not the problem. You are the problem.
Yes.
No, but night we have to have light there, Don't have something which needs digestion and which needs a lot of process. So if you have light in the
night.
What
is light in it?
Heat
and the light. What is wrong in sprouts?
In the morning, if you take sprouts, it is easily digested and the whole day you are
even night also. So in the with the sprouts you take fiber, you take eat mulangi, eat vegetables.
Hello, Harishankar, I'll tell you one thing. Yeah. See, out of the carbohydrate, protein and fat, fat requires a lot of energy for the metabolism.
Yeah.
See, you count on all the three things.
Yeah.
Carbohydrate, 1 gram of carbohydrate, 1 gram of protein, 1 gram of fat. Out of which, body requires more calories to burn the 1 gram of protein
fat.
Than other two things. That's the reason. You lose weight when you replace the carbohydrate or fat with more and more
protein.
That's the reason.
Why
protein doesn't make any difference at all in case if you eat in the night. So body itself takes care, that's more is taken care from the body.
So basically you are weakening your body system, you are understimulating your body system, saying digestion system is that.
Hari sir, abhi jo follow kar rahe ho bus to
how much protein we request per month? So that is his weight, no?
See,
that is my weight is 70, so I should take 70.
Sir, don't make life so complicated. Feel how you are. See, there's something called as intuition. Alright, we are. See, sir.
Hello, please.
So this is how I do.
What you followed when you reduced your weight.
So I'll tell you, there is one side you have science, other side you have art. Alright. We cannot always be driven by data all the time. So he was asking what portion to take. Don't make life so complicated. So art is what you do with science. So if there is data, what you do with it. For example, now we are talking about heart rate. I know people who can take 180, 185 heart rate and run fast. They can take it. Now, according to science, they should not be doing that. Alright. There's this guy called Hayden Ox. He won the Manadalta. He took heart rate to 214. And he was totally fine. He looked like he was relaxed. Now, according to science, he should die. But he should know safely. But he knows his body better. So he can take it to 214, he can sustain. Right. According to sports science, he should not be doing that. Right. So that is what you call as intuition, which we have lost. Depending so much on external factors, external feeding, we have lost the intuition completely. Alright. So you should know what is good for your body. Alright. The reason I quit meat was I was not feeling good. When I drank a glass of milk, no matter what the doctor, my auntie, my uncle bought the doctor, I said, I'm not feeling good. So don't make me do things I'm not feeling good. You might think it is healthy. My wife, my in-laws, they said you have to eat rice in the night. I feel heavy next morning. When I eat carbohydrates in this thing, I feel heavy in the morning. So I will not do that. Alright. So many people do carb loading for a race day. Tomorrow is race day, previous day they eat night rice, morning they eat bread. I don't. I still have my 2 o'clock meal and next morning I run the same. I feel good about it.
But right. For people like us who are running here, not many. So how do we monitor the heart rate? I mean, how do you?
So heart rate, again, you need to see, a lot of us do not have heart rate monitor. So you're breathing.
Comfortable breathing.
The moment your mouth opens to pull air in, that is when you need to slow down, close it and inhale from the nose. So too much of mouth, see, if you're last going in last 500, 600 meters, it's okay. But if you're opening your mouth in the middle of a race, you know that you are frailing off because your body is asking for a lot of oxygen which you're not able to take it. So I'll tell you about breathing, okay? Before breathing, I'll talk about what my routine, typical day routine. So I eat in a period of 8 o'clock to 4 o'clock. This is my eating pattern. Okay, so I do intermittent fasting, all right. So my morning meal is after workout. So now I'm slightly starting to take protein shake, only when I do very hard workout. So if not, I usually carry fruits from home. You know, I carry like 3-4 kinds of fruits. I carry almonds, I carry almonds, dates, one banana, Nendra Balin we call. What is that?
The bigger one.
Reddish.
The reddish banana and whatever seasonal fruit. So I have that and then I have a protein shake. And if I'm really a little more hungry, I go, depends if I run 30 kilometers, if I run 25 kilometers because I have a long day, I go have two idlis at Konark, period. That's all I finish. So then I go home, okay. I usually have either one small bajra roti or either next day I have a ragi roti. So again change, very small portion. But with that I eat a lot of vegetables, like 3-4 kinds of, you know, one day maybe. I'll have one portion of mushroom, one portion of Suvarnagadde. When did you eat Suvarnagadde last? Ask yourself, when did you eat banana palya last?
Ask yourself,
go read about the benefits of, I mean, generally elephant yam, the kind of detox it has in your liver. All right. Banana, when did you eat banana palyala? Banana, kai banana palyala. When did you eat last? Banana, raw banana. When did you eat Gendisul last? Gendisul, you really eat on this thing?
Sankranti.
That's all finished there only. Gendisul that day you make. Ask yourself, when did you eat Gendisul last? It's the season for Gendisul. Gendisul with skin. You have to eat with skin. It is. You have to read the effects of what Gendisul skin has. Alright, it's amazing. When did you eat sweet potato last? So my, for example, when did you eat jola last at home? Instead of bringing that kara biscuit, kara bun, bring jola home and give it to your kids. Ask when you eat. So my meal will be like that. So when coming back, so I usually buy different range, whatever is there. I have that. At 4 o'clock in the evening, okay, I have a bowl of either peanuts or sprouts or rajma or channa and cloves. That's it. Sometimes I don't even have that if I'm not up to it.
So that protein shake, whey, which?
No, Univet pea protein.
Univet,
don't go for whey. But at your age, you don't need, sir. You don't need, sir. Sir, for your level of activity, you don't need. So the only reason why I am taking protein shake is I have a certain goal and I'm trying to push myself really hard. So only for that, for quick repair, I need the protein shake. And that too, I do only when I do my hard workouts. That's why I started only 2 weeks back. But after another 3 weeks, I'll stop it. Only during that time I take it. It should not be a part of everyday life.
You don't take chapati, roti, nothing?
Chapati, no, sir. Roti. See, when you come out, it's fine, right? When we go out on a weekend
morning,
or something.
You know. Tell me what's your diet from
sir,
the
diet morning to night?
Sir, morning fruits, sir. Usually a lot of fruits. Okay. And if I'm only hungry, I have to eat this at Konark. Afternoon, I either have, you know, ragi roti. So when we make ragi roti, we put chia seeds, we put flax seeds, you know, we put different kinds of seeds and we make that, all right? Then you have millets visi belabar. Even when my wife makes millets visi belabar, she puts all kinds of millets. All right, next time we make millets pilav, next time we make millets pongal, brown rice, red rice. So that is what I have. Small portion, that's all. Then again, with a lot of that, lot of vegetables, 3-4 kinds of vegetables. All right, that has to be, there should be some kind of vegetable, like, you know, which is very rare, which people don't eat, like what I said, Suvarnagadde. Suvarnagadde, I'm a big fan of that, the elephant yam.
So your wife has a full-time job for you?
No, only one meal she cooks for me in the afternoon, that's all. Morning, I'm not at home. Sir, I'm telling you, it's no rocket science. It is just about half hour spending in a kitchen for yourself. Oh, tell me, to make Suvarnagadde palya, you just have to chop, put it in this thing, put some tomato, this, finished. That is all I'm saying. Alright, to make corn, what? I only make corn. I go put it in the cooker, I go put gendasu in the cooker, I put some kadlaikai in the cooker, you're done. Why do you need wife for that? I'm really saying. Why are you depending on that all the time?
No other enjoyment or all
of them. One more rice.
So you have to ask them. So you should tell them. So 4 o'clock, sprout or peanuts. Alright. So even in sprout, you have horse crab, then you have the green sprouts, then you have the regular sprouts. There is so much of sprouts that you have, alright. Then your rajma, your channa, alright. People say rajma, channa, I get gas. Eat fiber with that. Eat one cucumber and one radish.
One of the highest protein.
Yeah, protein. Chickpea. Hummus is so good. Beetroot. So, if you're saying digestion, eat one mulangi with that. See tomorrow how your stomach gets cleaned up.
No, cleaning is not a problem. I eat sprouts in the night. When you eat sprouts in the morning, you have got the whole day. Then in the night, you make something within 5 minutes and fall asleep. Why you have to spend time? Have a happy sleep. Why you have sprouts in the night?
So that is what I'm saying, sir. We are all different. That is what works for you. It is fine. Like I'm saying, there's no hard and fast rule for anything. So you need to take what works for you. For you, sprouts doesn't work in the night. Yes, eat in the morning, eat fruits in the night.
One more thing, what we do in food, no?
Slow transition.
They just remove it. Before that, beetroot juice. How many people drank? Okay, forget beetroot. When did you eat beetroot last? Last week.
3 days back.
Beetroot and orange. As an athlete, if you are into any fitness activity, orange and beetroot should be a part of your everyday diet. Beetroot juice should be a part of
your everyday
diet.
Orange?
Orange, if you not get something else, vitamin C.
Musambi, sir.
Fiber will go out. You can eat the fruit. So why I drink beetroot juices? So there's something called, I'll tell you an article. So there's a huge research done on beetroot. Beetroot is called as legal dope. Alright. So beetroot, pudina, shunti. Pudina and shunti have got high anti-inflammatory this thing. Alright, beetroot has got a lot of nitrates. So you need, if your blood is nitrate rich, alright, there's a lactic acid building up when you're getting tired. That's why you're getting tired. You need nitrates in the body in your blood to break it down. Alright, that is what you call endurance and stamina. So beetroot is a must every day. Alright, you're drinking in morning, afternoon, whenever it's okay. Beetroot. In orange season, eat a lot of oranges.
Yeah.
Vitamin C. Alright, so make this two.
Mosambi, orange, both is okay or not?
Anything.
Sweet lime is also.
Anything. Okay, make this to a part of your diet.
Beetroot only in the form of juice.
You can eat this also. Raw, you can make it palya. But make it any form. I like to drink it in the form of juice because I mix it with ginger and mint. So I like the taste. So if not, you can eat it raw also. So when you drink beetroot juice, next day your urine will be red. Okay, don't worry about it. Okay, my friend is started crying, something has happened. He was drinking beetroot juice every day. He is doing investigation, he's going to doctor, everything is fine, but he's crying. But then he told me, even doctors did not tell that he's drinking beetroot juice. Then I asked him, what is your diet and all that. Then he said he's drinking beetroot juice every day and he's being...
Sir, chocolates.
Sir, sweet. So the point is, don't go to extreme. Don't make every day a part of every day. Okay.
Only on Saturday, Sunday.
Sir, I have to tell you something. Like that's what I'm saying.
Even they say dark chocolate.
Dark chocolate is good. It's high in oxidants. Yeah.
How much is too much? And what is the quantity of beetroot juice to be taken?
Two beetroots. You make it in.
One glass.
You can mix it like beetroot carrots.
Yeah.
Yes.
Ginger. Okay.
No, nowadays
breathing.
A lot of happiness.
Happiness, yeah.
chocolate.
It should be dark chocolate.
Dark chocolate.
Okay, dark chocolate.
Cadbury.
Okay, 70% cocoa.
Not
okay.
Sweet.
One more popular question that a lot of people ask is alcohol. So alcohol, okay, there's a myth among the Indian society. Alright, alcohol, like even as parents, they say alcohol don't drink, drunkard is bad and all that. Alright. They never say drinking, they never say alcohol is bad, drunkard is bad. Alright. You know, basically, why they say it is bad? Because we have no control. We drink.
We fall.
It's a serious thing, right? You go bang your car somewhere, you come home, women abuse.
They start speaking truth.
Yeah.
Nice experience.
Okay. So the problem is the use of it. All right. So they say humans are very great at inventing. We great at inventing Facebook. It's an awesome thing. Great at inventing phone. But the problem is we do not know how to use it. We go excess. All right. So alcohol is again, if you know where to stop, like. You know, like they say, you know, if you're not drinking, don't get into drinking. Do not want it, all right? But someone who's drinking, all right, a couple of drinks is totally fine, all right? I mean, I don't know, there's some chemical in whiskey which is, they say, it's really, you know, highly anti-cancerous or whatever, all right?
Red wine.
What?
Oh, wine.
Red wine is good. Two glasses of red wine is good. Even whiskey also, like scotch, you know, like
yeah, flavonoids.
Yeah. What you should... Okay, and beer, all right? Beer is fermented, all right? You have barley hops in it and all that. Very good for you. Very, very, extremely good for your stomach. If you know when, one glass, two glass is really good for your stomach.
Those who are not drinking, they can start, no?
So there's something called as, so let me complete. There's something called as kombucha, all right? There's something called as kombucha. I don't know if you know kombucha. Do you know kombucha? Kombucha? So kombucha is a Russian drink, okay? It's a non-alcoholic fermented drink made out of tea. Amazing for the gut bacteria. Alright, see, because, sir. So we take antibiotics, alright, which kills the stomach, right? That is why we take antibiotics, they say eat curd rice, eat this, eat that, alright, because all the Now today we are talking about probiotics, until recently nobody is even talking about, alright. So your curd is again probiotic, Yakult milk is again probiotic. So better alternatives are, I'm not saying drink alcohol, but generally, alright, let's say beer is highly, you know, it's got good probiotics, alright, it's also anything that is fermented, your curd is again fermented, right?
Yeah.
Anything that is fermented to an extent is good, but no way to draw the line, that is all, alright. So, we are talking yesterday about blue zone solution. I think the doctor should read that, alright. So, they've done a research on centenarians, alright. The maximum where Japan, I think somewhere in Canada, they've taken China. Six regions, one region China, they've taken six regions and analyzed their lifestyle, why these people live the longest. And all of them have alcohol, like one or two glasses of wine, every day. Second thing is, they move every single day. None of them are runners, none of them go to the gyms. None of them do anything, but they do activity every single day. Like I was saying, if you are working out here and if you can't walk two steps, then there is no point of what you're coming and doing here. Alright, if you're working out here and going and sitting like this all day, there is no point. Like he's already depressed sitting like this.
You start.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, you start.
Third thing is.
Hold on, guys.
Okay, let me finish fast. Only time. Okay. So my for few of my friends is repetitive, but yeah, eight parameters they drew. Alright. First, eight parameters, okay. Very serious, no? Eight parameters they drew. What is common among these people? Why are they living healthy? Well, what is the secret to their centenarians, alright? The first thing was relationship at your home. Spouse. If you're fighting with your spouse, then there is no point. Alright. Because home is where you want to be peaceful at. If you're not peaceful at home, you go to Himalayas wherever you not be peaceful. Alright. You look. Couple who are in love with each other, okay, genuinely, husband and wife are very happy with each other, they don't even go to temple. When something is missing there, they try to find something there. They talk about philosophy, they talk about God and everything. If in house everything is happy, usually you will see they're very content, okay. So, second thing is sleep.
Do you get such houses?
There are people.
You should make it.
Okay. You have to make it work. Okay.
If not,
so,
find it.
So my friend was a psychologist. He says we always do things for the wrong reason. So you get married for security, like insurance policy. Marriage is like an insurance policy. Sorry to say that. It is not. So the moment you get married, oh, marriage. Now I have to earn more. I have to do more. Then why the hell you get married if you're always stressed?
No.
You get married so that 2-2 becomes 5. I mean 1-1 is contributing to your life better and better and better. Not to come and, you know, put like a jail. The moment we say marriage, we think it's a jail. Right? It is not like that. I'm sure there are many people who have done exceedingly well after marriage. Right? You know, they've contributed, especially in athletics world. Husband and wife, the way they at least in that world, they've done phenomenally well. Second thing is sleep. Alright? Sleep is very important. 8 hours is mandatory. You have to sleep 8 hours. And sound sleep. Alright? It is again personal thing. You might ask, how will I sleep? You need to answer for yourself. Alright, your life, you need to answer for yourself. At least 7 to 8 hours is mandatory. Third thing is stressless. Traffic. Do not scream at people. Do not be bothered about what. Do not stop thinking about things you cannot have control over. Because if you're always stressing, what is that hormone? Cortisol. In the body, it keeps
stress hormone.
Yeah, stress hormone. Even in traffic, you're abusing someone. Already your blood pressure is going up. That fellow will go. He will not care. Nan yaar gotta, adu gotta. He'll say, and he'll go. He'll score at you, and he will go. For you only, will feel bad. You cannot change him. Alright, when you can't change him, you have to change yourself. What is the point? Alright. If you so stop the worrying about things, that is beyond control. Alright. So fourth thing is, think positive. Think positive. Wish, you know, good for other people. You know, there should not be jealousy, envy, and all that. Fifth thing is, all these people, centenarians, they're working. Even Japan, why they live longest? Okay, one side they're depressed. That's a different thing. Okay, Japan is one of the countries when it comes to depression. One more thing is, they keep working. You have to work. That is what I personally believe. All right. You have to do some form of work until you are alive. All right, there's no retirement. There should be something to contribute to the society. Because everything that we're getting is from the society. Everything is that is getting is from the universe. So they say you should always have a intent. They call it ikigai. I don't know if you heard this concept called as ikigai in Japan. They always have a purpose to life, all right? If you look at Japan, when Nagasaki, Hiroshima bombed, they thought, where will the country survive? They were gone. Look at them, how they were, because they have a bigger intent beyond them. The problem why India is suffering is we do not have an intent beyond us. We are always, my, me, what am I getting, what am I getting, what I am, it is all about me. That's why a country is breaking down. It is very easy to break down India.
They bounce back with every disaster.
Yeah, every disaster. Yeah. That this thing happened. Why? Why are they so developed?
Amazing city. Yeah. Nagasaki.
Tsunami.
Yeah.
So why are they so developed and why are we like this today? Alright, because there is no us. There is nothing for us. As a community, we do not think. It is very rare what people think. So that is why in India, it is very easy to anybody to become, you know, to pull crowd or anything. Is you just have to be little smart. That is all. Indians are basically, we do not think beyond us. Alright, so they say have a bigger intent. Alright. So, and then the other one is nutrition, not just exercise. None of them went to gyms, none of them did yoga, none of them, ran marathon. So running marathon is not healthy, by the way, FYI. It is not healthy. You don't run marathon for health. You run marathon as a challenge. If you want to run, if you want to be healthy, run 5K every day.
Every day
run 5K. Rather than, I'm saying, so for me, you don't have to run a 21K or a full marathon for health I'm talking about. You run this for as a challenge. For challenge, that is a different thing. But if you want to be healthy, jogging, pranayama, you know, this thing. And most important thing is breathing. Alright, so breathing that is not covered. So what is the right way to breathe? So why should you?
Without
strain. Firstly, close your nose. For 3 minutes, you're done, you're dead. That is the importance of breathing. Not even nutrition, sleep and everything. If you close your nose for 3 minutes, you're gone. Right? Yes or no? So that is the importance of oxygen for you. So it is also important to know how to use it. Correct. What is the right way to breathe? How many times in a minute you need to breathe? Ideally.
The breath should be longer.
How many times?
Actually, we do 15 times. You can make it 3.
25 cycles per minute. That's what.
Average, that's what we do. Ideally, it should be 4, that is all. 4, only 4 times. Only 4 times, okay? So basically, forget pranayama or everything, alright? So basically, you know, we do this, that. That is all actually next level. B.K. Sayangar, the Vayangar yoga teacher. B.K. Sayangar, when he was taught yoga, alright? His guru was Krishnamacharya, alright? B.K. Sayangar was a dead person who thought he will never live. He had pneumonia, cholera, whatnot. He was in Kolar. So his brother-in-law pulled him and he came to Mysore. Alright, you should see video of Krishnamurti Tirumacharya in 1930 doing yoga. Today nobody has got that kind of body. That physique and the way they control. He lived up to 102. Okay, B.K. Sangar lived up to 95. B.K. Sangar was taught yoga after 15 years. I mean yoga no, pranayama. Today you go to yoga, first day only, the second day headstand. Third day, no, I don't know what happened. Third day, you become a yogi, they put your home tattoo. That's what is happening in Bangalore. Yeah. They'll have a studio, they'll say, I'm a yogi and all that come. Yeah. So yoga is what you do outside the mat, not on the mat. Alright, so breathing is forget about pranayama, kapalbhati and all that. So learn how to breathe. Breathe slow. Alright. So science says that you take about 5 seconds to inhale. Alright. 8 seconds to exhale. The point is we do not exhale properly. Until unless you do not exhale properly, you will never inhale properly. Alright. So always the breath should be, when you say breathing, it's not your lungs that should expand, it's your abdomen. Alright. One of the success for Roger Federer's mindset, I don't know if Roger Federer was a very, very aggressive person, he used to break his rackets and all that. Alright. Today, if there's a lot of, nicety in the sport, I don't know how many people watch Formula One. Formula One is one of the most abusive sports because there's so much of money involved in it, you know. It is ruthless, alright. Nobody gives a damn. Even teammates also, they go hammer their car. But today, now, there is some camaraderie between teammates. They credit Roger Federer because Roger Federer is the first person to go across the court, to congratulate, to, you know, talk good about other people. And how he evolved, right, from smashing his rackets to he's looked as a world icon. That they say is a lot of how we change his breathing pattern. There's also a video how Roger Federer breathes, alright. So, your always breathing should always go to your navel. It should hit your navel. When you're breathing, this should expand. Okay, hold for a couple of seconds and slowly breathe out. When you do that, when you're doing that, your mouth, you will notice that you can practice when you go home. There'll be a lot of saliva collected in your mouth. It's a sign of saying that you're not getting dehydrated. The moment you open your mouth and breathe from your mouth, what happens? Mouth goes dry. Same thing happens with running. That is why when I say running, do not breathe from your mouth. Your mouth gets dry. Your breathing becomes shallow. You should inhale from the nose. Exhale from the mouth. Why you exhale from the mouth while running is because you can exhale fast. Try to exhale from the nose fast. You can't. Your mind, you start, you know, straining your head. Alright, so breathe out from the mouth, inhale from the nose. Inhale from the nose, every time. Exhale from the mouth, yeah. Mouth exhalation should always be from the mouth.
While running.
Only while running. Because why? Because you need oxygen more. When you're running, you need a lot more oxygen. The faster you breathe out, this is a technique you need to follow while running or walking. Not only from... No. Alright?
No, they say you can alternate. Some people, they say.
If you're running like a slow jog, you can do like a nose inhalation, exhalation. But you're doing a fast run because your body needs that much more oxygen to break lactic acid, right? So never open your mouth to breathe. The moment, one more thing about heart rate, all right? Some people say, I do not have a heart rate monitor. But like I said, the moment you open your mouth, you know that your body is overworking. And if you breathe in from your mouth, gets dried and lead to dehydration. So that is the technique while running. So while being otherwise or even after finish your run, just sit. Focus, count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to inhale. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale. And hold your breath outside. Alright. We'll do a small test before we go, okay? So close your eyes. Okay, so basically, this is a test. I'll tell you the score. It's called as a Bolt test. Okay. It's a test they do for the athletes. Alright.
What's the thing?
No, you're not using bolts, breathing. It's called as this thing, okay. So inhale fully, inhale. Full out, exhale out completely. Full out, exhale. Okay, full out, exhale. Full. Okay. So after that, you just have to close your nose. Okay. You have to close your nose. At the first instance, you can remove. At the first instance of you wanting to breathe, do not force yourself. I mean, you can hold this for like 2 minutes. I don't want you to force yourself. The first moment your body is saying, I want to inhale, that time open your mouth. Open your nose. I'll give you a count. Okay. So when you open your nose, keep that count in your mind. I'll tell you what that number indicates. Okay. Take a deep breath, full score. So it says that, so if you see them, they're very young, they're athletes, all right. So their blood itself is so oxygenated that they're not depending so much on external oxygen yet, all right, because their age is on that side. So if your score is below 10, you're very poor in terms of health. If your score is between 10 to 20, you're average. 20 to 30 is good. Beyond 30, you're exceptional, is what they say. Because that is what is your capacity. I'm not saying, I don't know if you force, if you're forcing a trying to hold, that's a different thing. So your body is still not asking for the oxygen. So you can read about it. It's called as, there's this book called as Oxygen Advantage. All right, that's pure science about breathing and numbers and all that. Very breathing, simple techniques. If you want to learn pranayama, amazing, but learn from a good yoga teacher, somebody, you know, who spent a lot of time there. If not, you know, pick up this Oxygen Advantage, which is done by your doctor who spends time in lab and all that. Any questions?
Some people are able to run long distances. Some people aren't able to run, even though physically they are not weak or something. Why?
Practice.
How to improve?
Practice. Everything, sir. That's what I said. No, there's no one. So that's what I was trying to say. The entire conversation was, I never said your feet like this, your feet like that, your feet like that. Life is a combination of many factors. All right. So some people are not able to run fast is because there'll be many issues. Even they look fit. For example,
not talking about fast, I'm talking
long.
About long.
Now look at them. Arjun and what's his name?
Nipun.
Okay. They look very nice, lean, everything. All right. But look at the posture. How poor it is. They look fit. No. Nipun was running. This was this side. It was here. Arjun working, trying to develop app. Body's become like this. Typing on right. Seriously, don't get me wrong. He spent so much on his computer and he's become like that. But they both, if you look at them, they both look the fittest. But if you look at Pramod may look big, but look at the way how steady he was running. I'm generally saying, alright, because Pramod does not spend too much time on computers. No, I'm just saying the example. Alright. So there are many factors, right? Not just because they look fit does not mean they're very healthy. Alright. Or maybe, what do you say? If you look at doctor, he looks very cool and calm now. But his heart rate is going 180. I'm generally saying, right? There's no one factor. That is what the beauty of life is. You have to figure out what works for you. So Yuval Noah Harari says, I don't know if you know Yuval Noah Harari, please read his book or say. He says, in a world where everything is so external, first go try to know yourself. Do not let people say, this is it, that is it. You take information from people,
your body will give you
You decide what you want. Because there is so much information. There is so much of information, there is so much of crap outside. You know, everything, you go Google, you'll get so much, right? In this world, anybody who's got knowledge about themselves will be the most powerful person.
Is there any formula, any trick wherein we can improve?
Sir, there is no...
We are doing some mistake wherein we are not
able to... Sir, training plan, yeah. Okay, last one. So there is no trick, sir. The trick is to know what works for you. Like I said, if you want to be fit, like all I said, you need to figure out, like you said, for your sprouts, you said in the night does not work. So eat fruits at night. So there is no trick. The trick is to find what works for you. So to run, first you need to have right strength. That's what I'm saying. These are the fundamental factors. You have to do strength, you have to do stretching, you have to do mobility, you have to eat right, you have to sleep right. If you're not doing this, no trick will work. This is the trick, to do this every day, all the time, to be disciplined. This is the only trick. If you trick, that will trick you back some other time. You know what I mean? So there's no trick. Now, if you want to run better, you know, you have to reduce 30 kilos. How many you will reduce 5 kilos? That is awesome.
7
kilos. The moment you reduce 20 kilos, all this will come out. So that is why you're using for safety, because when you're playing badminton, your body is not agile. Your body is so big, it is not moving. The moment your body will want to move, your leg will not move. That is when your knee gives up. You move, this move, your quads will move, your not knee will move, knee will not move, this will happen, ligament or whatever. So you're still not confident. So if you want to play badminton for life and if you have to enjoy badminton, you have to reduce weight.
Which one is better, going in loops or long distance?
Running, I'll tell you. Okay, so running should always be 3 days. Alright, so 3 days of running, nothing more than that. Okay.
Beginners also.
3 days of running.
Beginners
are 5 kilometers
initially.
So that is for people who do not want to train for marathon or anything. For someone like him, if he wants to lose weight, every day he has to run 5 kilometers. That is more.
Every day running is okay.
Up to 5-6 kilometers.
Thanks.
But if you're looking at a half marathon, full marathon, you need rest, you need recovery.
Okay.
Alright. So now let's say Shreyas wants to run a half marathon. So a 10 typical program will be. Saturday is a long run. So please keep Saturday long run. Sunday keep for leisure activity. Mm. Alright, because so that you sleep well, sleep in the afternoon and all that. Mm. Saturday be done with the long run. So usually Saturday should be a long run. Alright? Sunday should be more like swimming, recovery, stretching, yoga,
cycling.
I would say if you have an option, go for a yoga class and go for a swim. It is better than cycling.
Okay, sir.
Okay, it is any day better.
Past 4 years we have done cycling.
You have to. It's a social activity. That's what I'm saying. So, sir.
Only 10 kilometers.
Survival of our club is very important now.
We can't stop it. You have to stop cycling on Sunday. Come again.
If we stop us, that also.
Cycling club.
One. So Sunday, I would say, if you're serious about running, is call everyone, go for get one yoga teacher, do some yoga, do some stretching, do some foam rolling. You know, I don't know if you have gymkhana or wherever, you go to the ground, go for a swim. Swim is amazing. One of the best things you can do is swim. If you can swim, at least 2 to 3 times a week, nothing like it. Body opens up and low impact, sir. Very low impact because water. Okay, you can do all these exercises, you can do it in the pool, butt kicks, high jumps and all that.
Swimming is not good.
And Monday should be strength. Monday should be a good strength workout, especially for lower body. you know, those, you know, resistance band workouts, squats, lunges. Tuesday should be a speed workout. Your speed workout. Now, let's say it could be, for someone as a beginner, it could be just 100 meter, little run fast, 100 meter jog. Slow, all right. Maybe for someone who's looking, if you're doing a 10K program, it should be 400 meters, 800 meters repeats, 400 meters repeats. It depends on person to person, all right.
Intermittent.
Yeah, intermittent high intensity workout. Okay. And Wednesday can be another day where you work on your core and foam roll or go for a swim. Thursday should be more like a, if you ask me, it should more be like a relaxed, maybe like 1 hour. Relax, focus on the form, posture, like how you did today, focusing on form, posture. Friday should be full rest. Rest, sleep well, around say wake up, just do some. Saturday, you should be pumped up for your long run. So Saturday is when you should save up. So every, this entire week you should build up for Saturday. Every Saturday you should, you should get better, 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 better.
How do you
get
a long run, sir? How long?
So for example, now let's say if you're running a half marathon, your long run will be 18 to 20 kilometers. Or if your goal is 10K, it can be 6 to 7 kilometers. For someone like you, you should, like I was telling you, for you should run at least 5 times a week. Because for you, idea is to get their heart rate down. In, as a beginner, if somebody comes in, we never give them programs. We never make them do high intensity, you know, for you also. For you, there's no point in doing intervals. You will not be able to last. You will get injured. For you, you can't even do high intensity workout. So you should be regular. You do a base building program. For anybody who's regular, do a base building program. All right. Instead of making, you know, not taking them for long workouts, half an hour job, 45 minute job, for 3 months, 4 months. Once they're comfortable, then you put them on high intensity program and all.
So if you're running like 1 kilometer in 6 minutes,
yes,
you say that high intensity you run faster for 400 meters or something,
yes,
how much faster?
So now let's say your goal is, you have done a 55 minutes 10K for example, okay, now your goal is a 15 minutes 10K, so it should always be a 16 weeks program. Now let's say if you are 55, you are at 55, I will say, sir, okay, in 16 weeks we will do, you know, we'll try for a 52 to 50,
okay.
So, some there, okay. So you for so 50 to 50, now let's say if you're doing a 400 meters, all right, you should be doing 400 meters at 4 minutes 30 seconds, not in 4 minutes 30 seconds, yeah, 4 minutes 36, that's about 13.5 kmph. That is how you should be doing your 400 meters. If you're doing, 1 kilometer, you should be doing at 4 minutes 45 seconds. So because our goal is 10 kilometers at that, all right, so we start, because you'll not be able to last 2 kilometers at 4.45.
Yeah.
So you do 4.45 per kilometer, then you do about like a 2 minute job, then you pick up. So next week we do 1.2 kilometers at 4:45. Then next week we do 1.5. Then we go 2. Then we do 5 minute 5K time trial. And then on race day we come.
Sir, which shoes I can do? I will take
80
minutes for 10K. Without shoes I can do 70 minutes.
So go for then, sir. I'm telling you, no. Since you're running half marathons, all right.
Why in Skinners, bro?
I have, sir.
Skinners. Use Skinners.
Skinners
are comfortable, no? Use Skinners. Okay, and don't look at pace for your age. You're how old, sir?
25, 25, 25.
Don't push too much. See, also once you get this thing right, go by feel. I always feel that you should go by feel. All right, don't try to, because what happens when you get older, you recover. If you get injured, your recovery will get
slow.
So that is why when I also say at the same time, when you're young, you know, when you're in 20s or 30s, or even early 40s, do not, like for Shreyas, I say, do not compromise on your pace. It's okay to get injured. You'll get injured. You'll recover. Even for them. You should never compromise on your goals when you're young. When you're young is when you
push.
Can go and push
Josh.
And do, because you'll recover. But once you're getting old, your body will not be able to adapt. Okay, and this is the time you should be recreational and not get all the stress. Now your stress is what this fellow will do when you get married, when that, okay.
Who will marry?
What is he doing? Okay.
So many affairs.
No, Shreyas, we saw a TCS 10K in Bangalore.
Why is Shreyas running so many marathons?
So many marathons, okay.
So in
my hamstring is paining, this is paining, that is paining. You don't want that stress, no. You finish the run, you go home, be happy. So that is why I would not, you know, people once they become, I see the person, then I decide what I should do. So for him, it's okay.
How old are you? How old are you?
24.
Arjun Martin.
See for him, if you do not give good problems at this age, all negative problems will come. If his hamstring is paining, he'll be focusing how to fix it. Tomorrow, so why I encourage youngsters to go into sports, see, when you, so that there's so many deviations today. There's so much outside, you know, drugs, social media, late night sleep, Netflix and all that. But once you put them in sports, they'll get disciplined. They know tomorrow they have to wake up 4 o'clock in the morning, it's Friday morning or Saturday morning. Alright, if not, see when you see youngsters who go for partying, you know, they have no intention of waking up Saturday morning. So they party till 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock. But youngsters like him, they will not do it because they know they have to wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning. So you sleep early, you can't watch Netflix, you can't keep chatting with a girl. Alright, I'm really saying, I don't know if you chat with the girl and come at 4 o'clock in the morning. Okay, so if you do that, you'll not be able to perform. So that's why.
In the morning.
The morning 4 o'clock is not chatting.
Yeah, Saturday says wake up 4 o'clock in the morning.
That is not the description.
Sir, he's on.
It's okay, let him see Strava and let him do what he wants that day.
No. He's chatting while running.
Is it? Chatting. That is okay, no, talking about mobile chat and all that, right? So,
yes, see, thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you, sir.
One more thing.
Yes, sir. You, sir. Come here for breakfast. We will take it very soon. Yes. Video, move.
Ballari, Ballari.